Fires the three. That doesn't go either for George. For Brooklyn, they've gotten exactly half their shots to go down here in the second. 5-10.
Boy, Chris Humphreys is clearly not flashy, but he is a worker on and off the court. He's always been a strong rebounder, especially on the offensive glass. So never afraid to get in there and battle. He never shies away from contact. If you want to get physical, he's not backing down.
Miles Plumlee.
Looking at who's out there now for the Wizards. Miles Plumlee's checked in for Blotch, and Martin subbed in for George. And it's Johnson penetrating. And there's a nice one-handed slam. No challenge from the defense there, but could have put that one through any way he wanted.
And I love the choice there, partner. Going hard to the hoop for that throwdown.
Yeah, that's invisible defense leading to a very visible finish.
And Humphreys, lightly regarded as a defender, but, you know, Steve, I think he made some strides last season.
I agree, Kevin. He blocked shots at a high rate. You know, in the past, he struggled against the quicker power forwards, but he's got the size and strength to deal with the real strong fours around the NBA.
Boozer, no good.
I'd love to see them impose their will a little bit more on the backboard. Usually that's a great way to take control of the game.
Well, they haven't been able to do that yet, but it's something they're certainly capable of.
Miller, that's for two. And again, no good by Brooklyn. Smith dishes to Plumlee. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. They get Carlos Boozer.
You know, one of the things the Nets did last year that was pretty impressive, they found value in a number of players who had been overlooked by other teams in the league.
Harrison, he's checked in for Mike Miller. And the Wizards making a change here as well. Wall's checked in. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on John Wall. That's his first foul. Mason Plumlee's checked in for Brooklyn. Williams attacking. And that one's good. Williams has got six in the quarter. With the Nets, they did make strong role players out of guys that Steve didn't seem to be on anyone's radar.
Well, it gave them a lot of flexibility over the summer in terms of what they wanted to do personnel-wise. You can never discount how much that can shape the future of a franchise.
Now here's Williams. He's got eight. Humphreys against Johnson. Brooklyn needs to get off a shot here. It's taken away by Smith. And Wall kicks to Martin. Passes it to Plumlee. It's Wall with the drive. Got a piece of it. Plumlee with the steal. And out of bounds as the Wizards gain possession.
20 seconds on the shot clock.
Here's Wall. 17 points in the game. In the corner, Smith with it. Martin kicks to Wall. Pass to Smith. Dishes it to Humphreys. Out to Smith. Just five on the clock.
J.R. Smith.
Hands it from downtown. Smith's got 7 points in the game.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Timeout called, the Nets.
Well, I don't really know what to call it other than maybe the shoelace incident. But remember last year, J.R. Smith got himself into trouble for untying Sean Marion's shoelaces during a free throw.
Changes. Boozer, he's checked in for Garnett. Dudley comes in for Joe Johnson. And it's Ellison for Hairston. The Wizards also changing it up. Blotch comes in for Plumlee. And Gordon subbed in for Chris Humphreys. Now here's Williams. 8 points for him. And with J.R. Smith, it proved to blow up into a major distraction for him and the team. And while some applauded him for not taking things too seriously, most gave him flack for not being 100% mentally into the game.
Yeah, and you know, the problem simply, Kevin, is that it is an accumulation of those kinds of issues with J.R. that lead to people thinking that he's not quite locked in and focused. And that really might not be the case, but it's the impression it leaves. I think he's got to be more businesslike between the lines on a regular basis.
The kick out to Williams. Dudley the pass to Ellis. We've got 1:23 left in the first half. And, oh, here we go. Smith's got it. The fast break chance.
Oh, my goodness. What a huge play.
Now, Clark, that is just ridiculous.
Absolutely filthy.
Oh,
I don't remember ever seeing a dunk like that in a game. I certainly can't remember the last time I saw it.
Oh, man, that was just amazing.
Now, here's Ellis. And it's blocked by Gordon. And there's going to be a foul. He definitely made contact with the ball, and in doing so also got the body, so we'll see free throws here. Brooklyn shooting their sixth and seventh free throws in the game.
Monte Ellis at 6'3 is certainly a gifted scorer. He played most of his career minutes at the shooting guard position. He gives up some size there, however, and that's been a challenge for him at the defensive end.
Looking at who's out there now for the Wizards. Paul George comes in for J.R. Smith. And it's Peyton Siva in for John Wall. Here's Siva. Outside Martin. Here's Siva. He's guarded by Williams. Back to Martin. The 17-footer. Again, the Wizards good for two.
Look at that lead up and down the court. They have been in complete control all night.
And it's kept this building as quiet as a library. These fans have had nothing to cheer for.
And stolen by Gordon. Siva kicks to George. Siva dishes to Martin. Got a piece of it. Here's Blotch. Getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. An exceptional performance from John Wall.
He went off in the first two quarters, guys, as he's capable of doing. We might see some changes here in the defensive approach they use on him in the second half.
Yeah, they've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him like he has been.
Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
We've seen John Wall handling his business. 22 points, and he sprayed home three three-pointers as well.
Yeah, productive day for him from long range.
And on the floor for Randy Whitman as we get into the second half. Martin is out there with Humphreys. Then there's Etuan Moore. Then it's Peyton Siva. And it's Blotch in at the center. Washington leading now by 23. Siva kicks to Martin. Here's Moore. Out to the right wing. Outside Martin. The Wizards working the ball around now. Second chance shot. And that one's good. Moore's got 7 points.
Well, there you go. If you're going to continue to give up open jump shots, you're not going to get back into this game.
Johnson again. Smart. Johnson attacking. Boozer passes to Biombo. Goes back up. Kicks it out to Johnson. Here's Hairston. And the rebound goes to Martin. Martin's got his 6th rebound on the night. Kicks to Humphreys. Back to Martin. And there's the feed to Blotch. Again, the Wizards score.
Andrew Blotch.
Good job there, Kevin, getting himself a little space on the inside.
For Brooklyn, they've gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Here's Ellis. Takes the 12-footer and hits. Ellis has got 8 points.
That's the kind of finish we've gotten used to seeing from him in the low post.
Moore dishes to Siva. Humphreys against Boozer. Siva kicks to Moore. Feeds to Blotch. No one near him. Almost, but it rolls out.
Very tough when you have that good of a look. The defense caught a break there because he missed. Well, so much was expected of the Nets last year after they made all of their big roster changes. But it was a very slow start for them, and things were not very good in Brooklyn to begin the season.
Siva can't get it to go.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I thought so too, Clark.
Kicks it out to Johnson. Shoots. Kept alive. There's the pass to Hairston. Ellis against Martin. Ellis, the pass to Biombo. Left side, Boozer. A second chance effort. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. And injuries made that slow start seem dire at times, Steve. But, you know, you knew that the Nets were better than how they started the season.
Well, what was important is that they believed they were better, and they started playing like it. They didn't panic or try to make drastic changes. They just buckled up and played through it.
Martin from outside. And another miss by Washington. Here's Hairston. Yes, and it's Ellis picking up the assist. Ellis has got 3 assists now in this one. Wizards leading by 20. The dish now to Moore. Outside for Martin. Humphreys the pass to Martin. Here's Blotch. Kick out to Moore. Tries to keep it alive. And out of bounds as Brooklyn gains possession.
Where was he going with that pass? I mean, that's just an awful turnover.
Ellis with it. He's got 8. Hairston kicks to Boozer. Biombo down low. Blotch covering. That drops.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint. You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
Outside, Martin. Siva kicks to Moore. Outside for Martin. He dishes it to Moore. Blotch inside. Tries to snap the cold streak. And good as it just snugs right down through the net.
I like the way they got the ball inside there.
Ellis right side. Deflects the pass. Boozer dishes